Laerdal and SonoSim proudly announced the integration of the SonoSim ultrasound training solution into our patient simulator platform. This means you can now include diagnostic ultrasound featuring real ultrasound cases with pathological findings into full-scale simulations.
Laerdal is clearly the leader in terms of patient simulation, and they realized that there was a paradigm shift occurring in medicine, and the fact that ultrasound has become a critical part of how we assess patients.
At the 2016 International Meeting on Simulation in Healthcare, held in San Diego, California, we spoke to Dr. Dan Katz to get his view on this new and exciting integration.
So today we're here in San Diego at IMSH, and we had a chance to show people what it is that we've been working on. And it was phenomenal. We had several scenarios that we demonstrated today. We just did a case of a man who has fallen off of the second story of a building. He comes into a trauma center, he's altered, he's having difficulty breathing, he's got bruising to his right chest wall, and we're trying to figure out why the patient's blood pressure is so low.
Oh, my chest really hurts.
Airways intact.
We start him on oxygen, we put an IV in place, and then we're going through our trauma assessment as we would in real life, and that would include focused abdominal sonography and trauma, or the FAST protocol.
And this really replicates what I would do in a real emergency department case.
We look for fluid in his abdomen. We scan his right upper quadrant, looking for fluid between the kidney and the liver. We scan down in his pelvis to see if there's any fluid accumulating around the bladder. We look between the spleen and the kidney, and we see nothing there. Next, we look at the heart to see if there's any evidence of fluid accumulating around the heart, preventing it from filling. Nothing there. We check the left chest. We look for any evidence of collapsed lung there. It looks normal. And then finally, we get to the right chest, and we clearly see that there's a pneumothorax. And not just a pneumothorax, a tension pneumothorax, which is when the entire contents of the mediastinum, the middle of the chest, are being shifted. And that prevents the heart from filling. And in this case, it explains why this patient, who has fallen from a second story, is presenting with a low blood pressure and literally about to die. Up until now, how have people been able to integrate ultrasound into the simulation? It's been really difficult. I mean, you can run everything you do on the mannequin. You can intubate. You can do an EKG. The mannequin blinks. It has a seizure. You can put in a catheter, but if you wanted to do ultrasound, you couldn't. With the integration of the SonoSim technology into SimMan and SimMom, you're now able to take a probe and scan that mannequin, scan a gravid abdomen, scan the heart, scan the chest, and see real patient ultrasound data. For SimMom, the first case that we did was a woman in late stage pregnancy. We didn't know that she was pregnant. We know that she was found altered in a car. And we're thinking, wow, could this have been something in her brain? Could she have had a hemorrhage? Is this a drug overdose? We're not really focused on the abdomen. All we have is an altered patient. So she comes into the emergency department. We get her airway stabilized. We make sure that she's getting oxygen. We start an IV. You see that we check a fingerstick glucose to make sure that she's not hypoglycemic. And as we're doing our assessment, the patient suddenly has a seizure. And, wow, that's concerning. Now we're really thinking something's wrong in the brain. So the patient gets some Ativan to stop the seizure. And we remembered that she was found in a car, and potentially she could have a bleed in her brain from trauma. So we decide that we're going to do a quick scan of her abdomen, a focused abdominal sonography trauma. We scan her right upper quadrant, and it looks normal. The kidney looks normal, the liver looks normal. There's no evidence of fluid between the kidney and the liver. So next we scan the pelvis, and in the pelvis we don't see a bladder, we see a baby's head. And then suddenly everything comes together. An altered patient, she just had a seizure, there's a baby in her abdomen, her blood pressure is high, that's eclampsia. So we call for magnesium. 6 grams of magnesium IV are given, followed by 2 gram per hour drip. We ask for blood pressure medications, in this case we gave labetalol. We call the OBGYN who's on call because we want them to come and assess the patient. Now, while the obstetrician is being called, we decide to do a pelvic examination. We need to see, is this woman in active labor or not? If she's in active labor, we may need to take her for a stat cesarean section. If she's not in active labor, we can stabilize the mother, make sure she's oxygenated, make sure that there's no seizure activity, and then we might actually be able to deliver the baby safely through a regular vaginal delivery. At the same time, we start putting on the fetal monitor. So we put on the tachometry to check for contractions, and then we put the heart rate monitor to see what's going on with the baby, and that strip is nicely displayed on the monitor. And baby seems to be doing okay. There are some decelerations. The obstetrician finally responds, and then as a team, they make a decision on what is best for this patient. But for our part, we have stabilized her airway, we've terminated the seizures, we've used ultrasound to determine that this woman who's altered is actually altered because of eclampsia. We're incredibly excited about this product because it allows you to replicate a clinical scenario as it would occur in real life. It's hard to imagine now going through a cardiac resuscitation, going through a trauma resuscitation without having ultrasound at your side. And any simulation that doesn't integrate ultrasound is not replicating what's occurring in real life. This is the only product out there that allows you to do that. It's incredibly exciting. We're so happy about this partnership.
Thank you for joining us. If you would like to hear more about how Laerdal and SonoSim can meet your healthcare performance needs, please find us at www.laerdal.com or call us at 1-877-LAERDAL. Laerdal Medical, helping save lives.